about Congress in general. Josh Rogers has a question about this topic for Ms. Shea-Porter.
Ms. Shea-Porter, a Gallup poll taken this summer gave Congress a 10% approval rating, which is the lowest ever. 2 years ago, that rating wasn't much better. It stood at 20%. Why do you think Americans rate Congress so poorly?
Well, they can see all the quarreling and the struggling, but there's also a huge ideological fight that you see going on here right now. And the question is, does the Tea Party continue to run Congress, or do we turn back and go back to the center? And so, you know, we had our difficulties, and I have to say that we could all do better for sure. But the 110th and 111th Congresses were called the most effective since Roosevelt. And Congressman Guinta's Congress has been called the worst Congress ever. There actually was a book written about it by a very conservative Republican who is with the American Enterprise Institute and a fellow from the Brookings. And they wrote the book, and it's called It Worse Than It Looks. And it said that they can't get anything done because they're locked in ideological cement. They don't listen to fact. They don't listen to science. And they simply don't want to find a way to compromise. And I think people see that, and they're responding.
All right, Mr. Guinta, why are people so fed up with Congress?
Well, very quickly, people are frustrated with the debt and deficit. People are frustrated with the lack of growth in our economy. We had 43 consecutive months of 8% or higher unemployment. But the reality is 2 years ago, the country across all states threw out that Congress because of the spending, because of the borrowing, and because of the taxation. And the country wanted a check on the president and a House of Representatives that was Democrat, as well as a Senate that was Democrat. So we are in place now for 2 years in the House of Representatives, trying to reach across the aisle and focus on economic issues, reforming and retooling the size and scope of government, ensuring that we reduce our $1.1 trillion deficit and $16 trillion debt. So we have offered facts, we have offered solutions. But Josh, people are rightly so frustrated. I join in their frustration. I served as a mayor with 11 Democrats on the board, two Republicans, and one independent. And I was able to deliver a 50% cut in borrowing, the first tax cut in a decade, a wealth of resources for public safety. And we did it in a bipartisan way.
Let's expand a little bit on the division that we speak of down there.